All right, let's just get right into it. I'm going to be talking about the Kings versus Warriors series so far. The Warriors' offense in Game 1 was okay. They didn't shoot great from deep, shooting 32% that game on 50 attempts. Specifically, Andrew Wiggins, who shot 1 for 8 from deep and missed an open one from the left corner. That would have won the Warriors the game. Defensively, they were okay. They held the Kings to shooting 44.9% from the field. They had 7 blocks, but they got killed on the glass, giving up 17 offensive rebounds. Draymond and Looney that game did a great job guarding Sabonis, making him uncomfortable with their physicality, holding Sabonis to 12 points and 5 of 17 from the field. But they couldn't stop De'Aaron Fox and Malik Monk. They combined for 70 points, 21 of 40 from the field, 6 of 12 from deep. They carried the Kings offense constantly getting to the rim and hitting tough shots off the dribble in the fourth quarter. And Trey Lyles was huge off the bench, having 16 points, hitting 4 shots from deep. Defensively, the Kings got 10 steals, but their defense that game was anything crazy. In Game 2, the Warriors' offense was not great. They shot 32% from deep again. They had 20 turnovers. Steph struggled this game. Both him and Wiggins shot bad from deep. Jordan Poole was terrible. Poole shot terrible both from the field and from deep and was unplayable that game. Defensively, the Warriors were good. They didn't let the Kings kill them on the offensive glass, and the rebounding battle was tied. The Kings offensively were okay. They did shoot bad from deep, shooting 23.7%. Sabonis bounced back from Game 1, having 24 points, 9 rebounds, 4 assists, shooting 8 of 12 from the field. De'Aaron Fox shot bad from deep, but still had a solid game. He went crazy in the fourth quarter, hitting timely shots. Harrison Barnes was huge in the fourth as well. Malik Monk and Davion Mitchell were good off the bench, with Monk having 18 points and Davion having 14 points. Defensively, the Kings were good this game. They forced the Warriors to have 9 turnovers in the first quarter. They set the tone early. Davion Mitchell played great defense on Steph this game, especially in the fourth quarter. Steph had 13 points, but he shot 0 of 5 from deep. Davion made him work hard for every shot. De'Aaron Fox, Harrison Barnes, and Davion combined for 9 of the Kings' 11 steals, and Kevin Huerter off-ball defense this game was impressive. He was solid at reading passing lanes and navigating screens. In Game 3, the Warriors' offense was not good. They shot 40% from the field and 32% from deep on 50 attempts, but Steph had a great game, having 36 points, shooting 48% from the field, 50% from deep. Wiggins had 20 points, shooting 50% from the field and from deep. Kevon Looney was great. He had 20 rebounds, 9 of them were offensive, and had 9 assists. Dante DiVincenzo did a little bit of everything, having 6 points, 7 rebounds, 3 of them were offensive, and 8 assists. Moses Moody was good off the bench, having 13 points. Defensively, the Warriors were great, holding the Kings to 38% from the field and 23.4% from deep. Now, the Kings did miss a lot of open shots from deep, but the Warriors were still great defensively. They forced 12 steals. The Kings offensively were terrible. Fox and Sabonis and Harrison Barnes had solid games, but everyone else struggled. Kevin Huerter, Keegan Murray, Malik Monk, Davion Mitchell, Trey Lyles, and Terrence Davis combined to shoot 5 of 28 from deep. Defensively, they were great as well, but their offense was too bad for them to keep up with the Warriors. I appreciate you watching the video. If you could like the video and subscribe to the channel, I would appreciate it. Let me know in the comments, what team do you think wins Game 4, and what team do you have winning the series? And I'll see y'all in the next video. More content on the way.